much confusion. I can't get no relief. Businessmen, they drink my wine. Plowmen dig my earth. None of them along the line know what any of it's worth.
That was Leo Kottke. Leo, don't call me Chuck Pink Kottke, walking pensively through an empty house and playing his guitar. It's a tune that I love, a waltz version of 4/4 North, that being 3/4 North. And what about your video, Michael?
Well, we tried to do some videos, but the performance was so electric that it scarred the videotape permanently, and we decided to, you know, feed me tranquilizers, and they're just beginning to kick in now, so I'm going to play solo guitar live here in the studio on the next segment.
Well, that's why we used goldfish to the same effect in my video for that tranquilizing touch. And this is New Visions on VH1.
That was Frank Zappa and Peaches and Regalia. I'm Michael Hedges, and this is VH1 New Visions. This will be the first of several live performances we'll do, Leo and I. And the first one I'm starting out with is called Ritual Dance. Thank you. That was Surf Blue and Green by Elements, Danny Gottlieb and Mark Egan. We were often asked why we got, or how we got together to do this tour, and we've also been asked quite a bit what we should call this tour. We still don't know what we're going to call the tour that Leo and I are just starting. Do you have any?
No, I think the best thing to do is to avoid entirely any kind of name for this thing because of the fact that we don't yet know exactly what we're doing. We've been at this, what, about a week?
Yeah.
And one thing that's definite is that there'll be more duet material at the end of the tour than there is at the beginning of the tour. In Cincinnati, we had 1.5, possibly, lunges at it. Michael was better prepared than I was. This has been a privilege for me, though, because the only thing sounding better than one guitar is two guitars, and Michael is a terrifying musician, and it's something I've looked forward to for years.
Well, I've looked forward to playing with you for years as well, and I actually tried to do it once in Stillwater, Oklahoma. I had grown up in Enid, and one of my dreams was to go hear Leo play. So I did, and I took my guitar, and I finagled my way backstage and had my hand on his dressing room door handle when I got collared by a bouncer.
I have them around to deal with people like you.
But we'll be back to play, and this is VH1, New Visions.
New Visions. You saw Michael Hedges a little earlier. This is a tune of mine called Skin Flint.
Welcome back to the second hour of New Visions. I'm Michael Hedges.
I'm Leo Kottke.
And together we're going to scan the cathode horizon for new videos, and we'll be entertaining you ourselves.
That's a threat. A friend of mine is up next playing The Long Train Home.
Last Train Home. Have you played with him?
A dear friend of mine. I know his material well. I have played with Pat Metheny, originally when he was touring with Gary Burton. Playing that old blonde Gibson.
Yeah, well, he still does that with the toothbrush on the bottom of it.
I think so.
Yeah, I just did some gigs with him and the Pat Metheny group as well this summer.
It's a pleasure to hear him. I remember him playing a guitar about this long with strings that long about that big around. It still, for obvious reasons, is a puzzle to me.
So here's Pat. That was Cloud Busting by Kate Bush. What a singer, what a arranger, what a writer, what a producer. I'm Michael Hedges, this is VH1, and this is Leo Kottke.
How do you do? Michael didn't have a video, I don't have a record. There is one floating around out there, but Michael has a copy here. And why don't you tell us about it?
This is my new record. It's called Live on the Double Planet, and it was recorded all over the place. It was recorded in Maine, Kansas, Alabama, L.A., Virginia, Toronto, Montreal. We just took out our tape recorder and did everything everywhere and came up with some music. I think you should get a close-up of this picture because This shows all my hair before I reeled it in.
Did you just inhale deeply to get that effect?
No, I just pressed this mole button and it comes in a little bit. So this is my new record. I hope that everybody who's watching the show goes out and buys it so I can buy a home in Malibu. And here's some more videos. We're gonna break.
I'd like to add to this that you've developed a way of broadcasting a guitar that is out of this world. The sound that you get live, and I think it's well represented on the record, is really unique. Probably the most unique thing about it is it sounds like a guitar compared to most of what we can hear these days. It passes for a guitar.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
That's Leo, I'm Mike, and this is VH1.
You will be hearing Michael Hedges a little later. This is a tune of dry guitar called Short Wave. Thank you. by another great guitar player, John Scofield. And this is the segment of New Visions on VH1 where one host turns to the other and asks, what is your musical fantasy?
Me?
My
ultimate musical fantasy.
I'm going to sit here and think of what mine might be.
Well, I have thought about this on a number of occasions, but not quite with those words, with that verbiage. It makes it sound sexual. I mean, we usually connect that term fantasy, at least I do. Musical fantasy to me would be to clear out all the garbage between my head and my hands, and that way I could continually act out any fantasy that I got in my head. So musical fantasy to me would be a clear nerve line. So if you know any those garbage men who with the bucket and the sweeper, like I can imagine those little guys, like one day, you know, putting me in a hospital bed and feeding me something that would let that happen.
Feeding you a guitar. I used to think that it would be nice to be consumed by my instrument. I've come to believe, though, that that's already happened. It's left me in a kind of state of suspension. I don't know where I'm looking. I think I'll look here. That's probably the best place. And it's left me with exactly the same thing. I mean, I would call it playing what you think, with no distance in between thought and action at the same time, which never seems to happen. And somebody you know well, Liz Story, made the point that it never is what you hope for it to be. So that fantasy will forever remain one.
Well, until
tough
we die.
Tough luck for it.
So if we could successfully die on stage, then it would happen.
You know what Carl Jung said about dying? He said that we all have the hunch that when we die, we'll find out what it's all about. His hunch is that when we die, all the dead people will come up and ask us what it's all about. This is VH1, New Visions.